Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
Shout out to all my tea sippers out there. We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey. So make sure you guys have your teacups ready because you already know this tea is what? Piping hot. All right, you guys, I want to come on and talk about the whole Wendy Williams and Kevin Hunter Jr. situation, okay? So as you guys already know, Kevin Hunter Jr. was arrested. This was about a month or so ago because he allegedly punched his father, Kevin Hunter Sr., in the face because he was disrespecting his mother. More details came out. I'm going to go ahead and read to you guys those details. Y'all go ahead and check this out. This is coming from Page Six, and they're saying 18-year-old Kevin Hunter Jr., was arrested in New Jersey on May 21st following a fight with his father, Kevin Hunter. Now Page Six can reveal the brawl began after Kevin Jr. called his father a bitch and resulted in Kevin Jr.'s arrest for domestic violence simple assault outside of a Crozier food store in West Orange, New Jersey. According to a heavily redacted police report released to Page Six on Friday, responding officers were told that things escalated after Kevin Jr.'s comment, causing Kevin Hunter to strike his son with a closed fist to the face, which Kevin Hunter later denied. The report continued, Kevin Jr. then stated that he called his father a bitch, which caused his father to approach him in an aggressive manner and started pointing a finger very close to his face. Kevin Jr. then admitted to pushing Kevin, which caused them to start wrestling with one another. The two were separated by a bystander, and Kevin Jr. then called his talk show host mother, who was not on the scene at the time. The family home is located nearby in Livingston, New Jersey, though Williams had recently been living in Manhattan. Okay, so those are the details of what happened that night between him and his father. Now, what I find funny is that only the junior was arrested, but he clearly stated that the father also struck him as well. So I don't understand why they were both not arrested. But I will say this, Kevin Hunter Sr. is not trying to press charges on his son. He stated that he doesn't want to press charges on his son because that's his son. But because of where they fought and, you know, it's a Commonwealth state, that anything, when you're arrested for anything domestic, regardless if it's male, female, father, son, mother, daughter, the state then picks it up. So that's what's going on right now. This case should have been dismissed. Okay, this was like a fight between father and son. This should have been thrown out. But of course, because it's high profile, it's concerning Wendy Williams, you know what I mean? They want to go on with this case. So as of today, Kevin Hunter Jr. was in court. His parents were not allowed to come in. It was just him because he is 18 now. And basically, he pled not guilty. So I'm going to go ahead and read to you guys what happened today. Y'all go ahead and check this out. So as of 10:46 this morning, Kevin Jr.'s attorney, Ray Hamlin, tells TMZ he expects the case to be fully resolved. Hamlin says Kevin Sr. is not interested in bringing charges against his son. What's more, there's a statewide condition dismissal program that Kevin Jr. can qualify for, available to those without a prior criminal record, to completely clear his name as long as he stays out of trouble. Then they also stated that Wendy and Kevin Sr. were in a car outside the courthouse, were told they were advised it was unnecessary for them to go inside because the case was continued. Kevin Jr. showed up to court and there was a change of plans because neither his parents showed up. He entered a not guilty plea. The prosecutor asked for more time so he'd have more time to review the case. The prosecutor said he wanted to review the factors in the case and said that he thought that the case would be resolved at the next hearing. That screams plea bargain or outright dismissal of charges. As of now, Kevin Sr. said he did not want to press charges. So that is what's being reported. So like I said, to me, this should have been dropped. It's not that serious. And it's really sad that a young man who has had no criminal record, he's not been arrested, he's not a bad kid by all reports. So, you know, for him, for his first experience with the police and getting a mugshot and having to go to court was behind his father. That is a damn shame, okay? And I'm sure Kevin Hunter Sr. feels bad because at the end of the day, that is his son, you know, that is his child. So I'm sure he does feel bad about the situation. But hopefully this gets dismissed. He doesn't need this on his record. He doesn't need, you know, this bogging him down. You know, it's clearly heated emotions. He was upset at how his mother was treated. Kevin Sr. is upset because he feels like the mother's brainwashing the child. But it should have been left as a family situation and not a situation for the police and the courts to get involved in. So hopefully by the time the next trial comes up, which should be sometime next week, hopefully this case will be dismissed and all parties can move forward with their lives and let the healing process begin, okay? So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire crazy situation. Once again, concerning Wendy Williams, Kevin Sr., and Kevin Jr. pleading not guilty. guilty. Do you agree with me that this case should have not made it to court, that it should have been dismissed, and that they should even picked it up as a domestic violence situation? And do you agree with me that they're only doing this because it's high-profile people involved, meaning Wendy Williams and her husband? So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. All right, deuces.